Live from the CBS Broadcast Center in Philadelphia, this is CBS3 Eyewitness News.
And now at 6, remembering the victims. It's been 1 year since one of the deadliest fires in Philadelphia history. This is Eyewitness News at 6, and we continue to stream live on CBS News Philadelphia. Good evening, everyone. I'm Yuki Washington.
I'm Jessica Cartaglia. 1 year ago today, a devastating fire tore through a Fairmount neighborhood home. Firefighters didn't find any working smoke detectors in the house. 12 people died in that blaze, including 9 children, and the victims ranged in age from 2 to 33. Eyewitness News reporter Marcela Baieto joins us with a look at how the community is honoring those victims. Marcela?
Jessica, Yuki, earlier today we walked through that Fairmount neighborhood and you could really feel the devastation, the pain from the neighborhood and those living in that area. And that same feeling was felt here today at the cemetery when we saw family members. We also saw local leaders, even the mayor and the fire department coming together to pay their respects. 1 year later, and a headstone honoring the adults and 9 children lost to the Fairmount fire stands at Shetland Hills Cemetery.
I want to let them know that we miss them so much.
With the help of community donations and sponsorships, the Lee Monument Company worked with families for the past 6 months to make the memorial.
We were all impacted by it like so tremendously throughout our community, and we're only African-American Monument Company, and we felt that it was a need for us to step in and for us to create this beautiful headstone.
At the cemetery, family and friends were joined by the fire department and city leaders for a balloon release. One by one, people came up to pay their respects, including Philadelphia Fire Commissioner Adam Teal.
This monument is important. This commemoration is important for you, for our city, for all those who've been lost over the years to the ravages of fires.
In Fairmount, the burned building remains with boarded up windows. Neighbors like Hannah Kohler walked by the small memorial of candles and stuffed animals to pay their respects.
And not seeing them come out was really difficult. And that was what made it a lot harder too, was just knowing that they were out here just being kids so often.
Each life will be remembered as a community continues to lean on each other.
You know, you still see the hurt. You still see the hurt from, you know, the tragedy. And I can really feel that this is something that kind of, not that it put closure on it, but it gives them a little bit of a, you know, that somebody did this, which is finalizing the location.
Now, organizers tell me that more than $20,000 was raised for this headstone. Live in East Mount Airy, Marcela Baieto, CBS3 Eyewitness News.
All right, Marcela, thank you. Stricter laws for smoke detectors. CBS3 has learned a lawsuit is about to be filed in connection to that deadly fire. A CBS3 investigation confirms that attorneys representing surviving family members will sue the Philadelphia Housing Authority over claims the tragedy could have been prevented. That lawsuit could be filed as soon as next week. A new federal law is also on the books mandating public housing buildings install hardwire, powered or long-lasting battery life tamper-proof smoke detectors. The president signed that measure last week. It was sponsored by both Congresswoman Madeline Dean and Senator Bob Casey. Meanwhile, attorney Tom Kline spoke exclusively with CBS3 about his case.
PHA could have and should have prevented this from happening. There was a overcrowded apartment, and there was a construction and a design of this unit which also enhanced the probability that there was going to be a fatality.
In a statement from the Housing Authority, they encouraged residents to have in place an emergency safety plan for their families, and safety of our residents remains paramount.